And now for the starting lineup for your Spayberry Yellow Jackets.
Flau’Jae Johnson, and well, that's kind of hard.
What? Come on, man, win more.
How many points?
I don't even know. I ain't even
she
heard.
She did 1,000 last year, so this gotta be like.
I ain't even heard them folk.
Folk, huh? Folk, sorry.
I'm a jack of all trades.
Okay, we got
that's
it.
That's a record.
Big folk.
It's your season. It's your season, baby girl.
Some people know me as a basketball player. Some people know me as a rapper. You probably know me as both.
Joined now by a very special guest,
Flau’Jae Johnson.
She's a hooper. She's a rapper.
She's already got a record deal with Rock Nation.
She's a little bit of everything, all-American baller.
I'm a basketball rapper. No, I'm just
She broke the school record. The amount of points she scored has never been scored.
Oh, man.
Yeah. So when she go to college, she gonna be at a 2,000, trying to get the 2,000 club.
Everything I touch, kind of good at. Because I like to be the best at everything. I believe I'm going to be the face of basketball one day.
Hi, Mom.
How are you?
Where's Ami? You know he needs his glasses.
Why did you steal our car today?
Oh, I needed it. I didn't put gas in my car, and I was late, and I had to take a quiz.
I don't
want to
drive your car.
Why you don't like my car?
Ever.
Why?
You have a hot car. The police is on that car.
Oh, yeah, they own it on me.
You got to get a low-key car.
I got pulled over the other night.
You got a highlighted gold Jeep.
I know. I said matte black in my defense, but then the gold just fits me. You know, I'm going to LSU. Purple and gold.
No, you need to switch your car before you go to school.
You think so?
Yeah, nobody needs
I should get like a Lamborghini or something like that.
God, can you afford a
Lamborghini? I will be able to in a month or two. NIL. NIL me.
Flau’Jae is the girl camouflage. I'm just gonna be real. Like her dad, personality, silly, you know what I'm saying? They get their bread, wanna flash it and be silly. Like just a genuine, good hearted, fun person.
Do I like a star? My glasses on like that?
I'm so sick of you. You going to play?
Think I'm like a star?
The first day I met Flau’Jae, she was this little mean little baby. I mean, not smiling when she came out the womb, just a mug on her face. And I was like, this girl gonna be about her business. I cried a lot during my pregnancy, you know, due to the fact that her dad passed away while I was pregnant. And I was asking God, why? Like, why me? Why my baby can't meet her daddy? You know what I'm saying? Why I can't, you know, have all these things that everybody else has? But God gave me the life that I needed to set myself up for better days.
Me and my mom, we got a real close relationship. You know, I just talk to her about anything. I could tell her anything.
It is just funny, because Flau’Jae was just a 10 or 12-year-old little girl, and she's in the bathroom giving me advice. You know, like, I'm getting my makeup on, she's like, listen, Mom. And I'm like, oh my God, this little girl just needs to shut up. And she was right.
Me and my mom, we always been close, for sure.
So right now, the McDonald's All-American list is coming out, and my stress level is up right now, because you know, I feel like I did really good, you know what I'm saying? But it just be a lot of politics and stuff like that, you know? It's scary, it make my stomach hurt. And this is lit, because it's like Kobe was on this list. You see what I'm saying? Like, Kobe the Bean Bryant, you feel me? Candace Parker, you feel me? Flau’Jae Johnson, you feel me? So it's like, yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I get it.
It's a lot of pressure.
But like,
You gotta think about where you came from, Flau’Jae. Them girls been getting evaluated since 7th grade. You started getting evaluated your 11th grade year. You have done it amazing. They
said I have.
They have never seen nobody move up in the rankings that fast.
But you know,
that was my fault.
I'm a competitor.
I've been competitive since birth. Like, I don't like to lose. I don't like to lose. I hate to lose.
Stay there. I got help. Scramble. Come on.
These games suck, bro.
Coach, take me out. You got ball. Stay. Stay.
That last layup, girl, hit me in my lip. I should go drop 40.
God, damn. Come on. Come here.
Flau’Jae knew she wanted to play basketball before she was a rapper.
I don't care what they might say. Simon Cowell said I'm a GOAT. That's on a light day. And Jermaine Dupri regret his decision when I'm on the mic's way. You could give a man 100 bands. He gonna spend it on a chain and his friends. I'ma invest in real estate. I had gain in some land. It didn't do it
for I had an early love for basketball. And then like, but the music just took off.
Soon as you go get a plate, real friends turn to snakes. The real man turn to hate. The bill man in your face. But I got myself in this perfect position to purposely pivot, preserving persistence. That's what it is, bro.
Well, I'm finding out about my dad. Everybody telling me how he was this big rapper. He was legendary, he's this. So I'm like, I want to do that too. And I really just kind of fell in love with music and I got famous off of it. Like I was like a little kid sensation, like around Savannah, like around Florida and stuff like that. We started putting rap videos on the internet and people was like, oh my gosh, she's a rap star, she's a kid star, her dad was a rapper. They took that whole story and ran with it. Cause then I got called to be on a rap game with Jermaine Dupri. That's when I was like 12 and I was like, oh, I'm a real rapper now. I'm on TV, like I'm like, oh my God, I'm lit.
Okay, all right.
The experience on America's Got Talent in the rap game really set me up for what I'm doing right now. Jermaine Dupri was literally in the rap game house teaching us how to be stars. Like how to come in the room and just command attention, but don't be a clout chaser. You know, like it just gotta be within you. Cause I on that show, I couldn't rap a lick, but still I had this like, this energy that was like, when she stepped in the room, you like notice her. It's nothing I tried to do though. It was never that. It was just like, I just had something in me.
So how did you fall in love with basketball?
It's just the sweetest story. Actually, I think basketball just fell in love with me.
She never was into the girly stuff. I put her in ballet. She was like, I hate this.
And it was just something about seeing the ball go through the net and swish perfectly. That just did something to my soul. All my kids in my neighborhood, they playing, they hooping, they not letting me play. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna get good. I was just dribbling this basketball all around the house. It was something that I could do all day and all night and not get tired of.
I talked to this guy and he was like, listen, I got a boys team, it's 6 and under. He was like, put on the team with the boys. And baby, she was the happiest thing in the world when she got that ball. The sparkle in her face let me know that's exactly what she wanted to do.
Oh, this money!
At that point, I was 13. Like, I'm a famous rapper right now. So I'm in the kitchen. I'm like, Ma, I want to play basketball. I don't want to rap no more. I'm sick of this. I'm crying.
When she finally came to the kitchen and cried and said she wanted to play basketball.
She like, well, you ain't just gonna stop rapping. You gonna do both.
Flau’Jae was an athlete. She wasn't a prima donna. She wasn't a ballerina. She was an athlete.
First day, I actually got to meet her in person. Met up at the gym. She walked in, I threw her the men's basketball and she caught it with one hand and palmed it. I said, yeah, this is gonna be different.
She's the best all-around high school player I've ever seen, and she can shoot, and she can drive, and she can dribble.
She can shoot the three, she can get to the rim, she can go right, she can go left, she can pass the ball. She will beat you in every facet of the game.
She's a dog. When a dog gets hurt, a dog doesn't know when to stop.
Let him keep fouling.
I was given a gift, and I thank the good Lord every day for it. She's one of a kind.
Camouflage was this rap name. My daughter's name is a bar. Flau’Jae Monet. And so I was like, oh, hell no, I'm not naming my kid that. Because I was like, my daughter got to get a job. He was like, she's going to be accepting resumes. She's not going to be needing nobody to read her resume. He passed away 2 or 3 weeks after that. And so I'm like, okay, God, this is the last big decision he would be to make for her. Flau’Jae Monet Johnson is her name. And it fits her.
Welcome, who are you?
I'm Flau’Jae.
That's a cool name. Where are you from?
I'm from Savannah, Georgia.
And how old are you?
I'm 14.
14? Wow. Okay, and who are you here with today?
I'm here with my mom.
Trey was about 4 years old when I had Flau’Jae. And I remember saying to myself, like, I can't be weak.
So why have you decided to come on America's Got Talent?
First off, I'm a rapper. I rap. Yeah. I started off because before I was born, my father, he was a rapper.
Yeah.
And he died before I was born.
Trey kept asking me, where is Jason? He's wanting to know when he's coming back. And that would give me some kind of sadness.
So he couldn't really fulfill his dream. So that's what I'm here to do.
For him. Good.
Jason was really my best friend, you know, like, but God gave me a piece of him. His mom, that was her only child, but she ended up with Flau’Jae, and then I ended up with Flau’Jae, which made and gave both of us comfort because we felt like he lived in her.